What's up, divas and devos? It's your girl April. So you guys already know what time it is. It's Real Talk Wednesday, and today is actually Tuesday. If you guys are not aware and don't know what day I record, I'm pretty sure you figure I record at least a day early because the video goes up at 4 o'clock in the morning on the West Coast, so that the people on the East Coast can watch it while they're getting ready for work. And if you guys need me to put it up earlier for the West Coast other than 6 o'clock, just leave your comment below and I'll be more than happy to. You know, it's on a scheduled time, and I figured like maybe 6 o'clock is early enough, but if you guys want it to be earlier than 6 a.m. on the East Coast, then let me know and I will do stuff for you guys. Not a problem. All I gotta do is just change the time. So anyway, so being that it's Tuesday, you know what I'm saying, it's Tuesday, it is Valentine's Day, okay? Valentine's Day. And no, I ain't dressed up. That's not why my boobs is out. I actually got on my workout gear because I went for my 3-mile walk today. And so I got up for that. But the first things first, I know y'all see the flowers, the balloons all on my bed, also on my floor over there. If you guys can see it, you probably can't, but there's a little black rug over there, right there. And on that rug, I have to show you guys a picture. It has some little heart-shaped petals and 2 big roses and a candy and a card. So all of this and that was actually done by my daughter, Tati, who is my grandson's mom, Tinky Man, who I'm always with. We just spent a lot of time together. She did this while I was sleeping, okay? So I really can't hear too well, not because I can't hear, because I can hear really good. But when you have entire carpeting through your house, sometimes you don't hear when people is walking up on you and stuff. So with me, I don't sleep with my door closed. You see my door is right there. But I don't sleep with my door closed because I just feel like I don't want to sleep with my door closed. I just feel like I need to hear everything. I need to know everything that's going on. And plus, my kids are down the hallway sleeping. So if something's going to go down, you best believe a bitch gonna know about it. So anyway, there's no door to open. My door is like slightly closed, but it's open enough to where you could just walk in. And I guess because I can't really hear you walking on carpet, I'm not disturbed. So when I woke up this morning at 7 o'clock to get Mumsy ready for school, because she lays next to me on that side of the bed, though she has her own room, she still feels the need to sleep with me. And I enjoy the company, so that's her side of the bed. I wake up and I look down to get out the bed, and there was all of those balloons. They weren't on my bed, of course. They were all over my floor, okay? So I was like, what the heck? And on top of that, they weren't just balloons. I thought they were just balloons, but each single balloon, all 25 of them, have a picture of me and my grandson on it. So they're all different, and each one has a picture of me and Tinky. And my daughter wanted the balloons to float, but she didn't know you had to have helium and not just regular pump. And they was going to float with strings and stuff. But she had placed them all on the floor. And the pictures, because there are pictures on it, the pictures kind of like turn them around. So that's why you can't see them like that. But each single balloon has a picture of me and Tinky taped to it. Like, that was amazing. I just was like, wow. These kids, my kids are like something else. So I took the balloons and I placed them on the bed for the day. Also, Mumsy, she got me some flowers, as well as Tinky Man got me the really colorful flowers. Mumsy got me the pink and white ones. She got me this. She got me some candy, and she made me a book of poems, okay, my 9-year-old. So I'm going to just read you a couple of things. You are the popcorn. I am the movie. You are my cookies to my cream. You are the strawberries. I am the smoothie. You are the waffle fries. I am the sliders, like the hamburger sliders. You are the hot and I am the dog. You are the cheese. I am the burger. Okay. You are the best. I am the friend. Okay. Sugar is sweet and so are you. Love you and you are warm to my heart. Okay, and it just got like pictures of little stickers that we had got from the 99 cent store that she used and stuff like that. And so when I was reading this, I started to cry because I was like, wow, she like really loves me so much. And I think that it's amazing. And so do my kids. Like, they really, really love me so much. I also got some things like these little balloons over there, like by my bedstand, and a card from my grandson. He says, "You are so amazing, Grandma, and everything you do, that nothing could be half as nice as having fun with you. Happy Valentine's Day to the world's best mum, Tinky." I was like, oh my God, this is so cute. Like, they love me. This was like the best Valentine's Day ever, seriously. And then I just sat there and cried and went for my walk for 3 miles, and now I'm about to drink this apple cider vinegar. And later on, since it's Valentine's Day and this is red, a bitch is gonna get really high, okay? Yes, just because this is red. This was my birthday gift from my daughter, but I'm about to really get high. I got some stuff, and yes, okay, so let's just keep that in mind. So other than that, I hope you guys, when you see this, the video will be the next day. So I hope you guys had a beautiful Valentine's Day. You know what I'm saying? It's amazing how much your kids love you and you appreciate it. So I thank them so much. And in case you weren't wondering about my scar, so it looks a little bit bigger today. That is because yesterday, which was Monday, which would be 2 days later, I went to get an injection, a treatment. So last week I went as well, okay? And when I went last week, I don't remember if I informed you guys, because I think I went on a Wednesday. So when I went, that doctor that originally did it, he was on vacation and I was not aware of it. So the doctor that was just taking his place temporarily, he was telling me that, oh, it looks too big. There's nothing you can do about it. You just need to go get a laser treatment and it'll come off in 15 minutes. And I'm like, no, because I've known quite a few people that have got these laser treatments to be removed. Not a quite a few, but a Caucasian young lady that I worked with. And it came right back. And a few people on Instagram have mentioned that to me as well. And the scar came right back. He was like, well, you can just keep coming in injections after you get the laser treatment, after you get it removed. So I was like, okay, well, how much does that cost? He was like, well, here's the car. I'm not sure what kind of insurance he takes. You might have to pay out of pocket. No, bitch, I'm not about to pay out of pocket for nothing, okay, because I'm already doing that for my motherfucking teeth. And he just kept telling me that it wasn't going to work. The treatment is not going to work. It's not going to go away. However, it was getting much smaller. It actually had gotten flatter because this side right here that I'm pointing to, I used to could take it and kind of like pinch it. I couldn't do it anymore. It was getting really flat. So he gave me the treatment, the injections, because I came there for them. But he didn't do exactly what my doctor did. My doctor, you just uses like, it's in this blue can, and it's some kind of thing that makes it hard and freezes it. And then he injects me like 6 to 7 times with the medicine. So the cortisone. So that doctor did not use the freezing stuff. He just came straight at me with the fucking needle ready to jab the shit out of me. So, you know, I was like, hey, whoa, like back the fuck up. And I asked him, where's the stuff at that my other doctor uses? Because you're telling me all these different things and you guys work together, but you're kind of totally against what he's doing, which is working for me. Well, that free stuff is not going to work. It's not going to make a difference. That's not what I was told. And I seen the difference in my scar. Within a couple weeks, it got flatter, a lot flatter. You know what I'm saying? And also lighter in color. So he didn't do the freezing thing. He just tried to tell me that it makes it harder for the needle to go through. Well, when he pierced me with the freaking needle like 4 or 5 times, it felt like somebody was stabbing me in my chest. You know what I mean? I could really feel it. And plus, the keloid wasn't as big. It was flatter, so I could feel it more on my chest cavity right here. I let him give him the injection. He tried to schedule me for 4 weeks later, and I told the nurse, I want to speak to my doctor. When is he coming back? She said Monday, which was yesterday. And so I went there, and I I was so pissed off, and I explained to him what happened and everything. And he was like, it's flatter. It looks flatter. And I was like, exactly. He's like, well, you're here now. I'm going to give you another treatment. I said, well, I just have one. He said, it's okay. More medicine into your keloid is not going to hurt it at all. It's just going to make the process faster. And so I told him about the freezing stuff. He said, I'm going to use it. He said, a lot of doctors don't like to do the old method like I like to do. They just want to do it the faster way. And he said, you know, that's his preference. He said, but if this is working for you, which is you have to come back for multiple injections, then this is what's working for you. Sometimes doing laser treatment doesn't work for everybody. And it seems like all the people that I know that have it here and have laser treatments don't work for them at all. Why would you want to go get something cut off that takes 15 minutes and then you got to come back and get it, keep cutting it off because it just keeps growing back? That just defeats the purpose. I don't want to have to go through all of that. So I'd rather let it slow and steady wins the race. You know what I'm saying? If this takes longer, if it takes months and months longer, then that's fine. You know what I'm saying? As long as it goes away and doesn't come back. Slow and steady takes the race. So when he ejected me, I guess because the stuff that freezes it, it makes it swell up. So now it looks bigger and it's darker because it's swollen and it's going to scab. Whatever the other doctor did doesn't give that effect to it where it swells up and scabs. And that's what it needs to happen in order for it to heal properly. So it's like you injected me like 4 or 5 times for fucking nothing. You know what I'm saying? I was so pissed off. Pissed the fuck off. But anyway, so yeah, so if it looks like it's bigger today, it actually is. It's not as flat as it normally is. It has gotten over because I just got an injection yesterday, and I got the injection the proper way. And that's just the one thing that I hate, because when you get an injection, it swells up, and then you have to wait, like, days for it to go down. Sometimes weeks, you know what I'm saying, because it gets harder again, but it takes, like, you will see, like, a drastic change in a couple weeks. And the doctor is actually right. You know, one day I looked in the mirror, because I stopped paying attention to it, but one day I looked in the mirror, and it was much lighter and way smaller, like, flatter to this side. And I was so happy about it. And now today, it's back to, like, almost to its normal size, and it's a little bit bigger, but it's kind of, like, temporary because I got another injection. So that's the downfall. And I think that has to do with the stuff that freezes in it, because it makes the tissue inside or whatever is inside of it harder, and it just helps the cortisone to get through it a lot better. So I will deal with it like this temporarily because it's going to go away for good, so I'm fine. But I just hate the fact that other doctors try to do some other shit, then they try to play you and throw you off to some other doctor where you got to pay out of pocket because are you going to make some money off of me? Because, bitch, no, that's not going to happen. You're not going to make no money off of me. I'm not going to allow it. But other than that, that's been my week. Still rocking my wig, my lace front from You May Hair. Oh my God, I love this fucking lace front. It's like everything, like seriously, everything. Like my favorite lace front in the world. And I think you guys know that because I stay wearing it now. I think this is like week 3, whatever. The hair is still really pretty. And you know, I got it glued down. I'm not even glued down, but gel glued down. You know what I'm saying? Like that, gel glued down. Not nothing drastic. I got a peep. Okay. Not nothing drastic neither, where you got like baby hairs all on the side of your freaking head. Like, no. Y'all know I don't do that. And I just look like this today because, you know, I just came back from on my walk. So, yeah, I'm looking a little crazy and shit like that. But my eyebrows are somewhat on fleek. Not really. You guys probably can't see close up, but I'm going to let y'all see real quick. If now y'all see that, right? All that hair. I have not plucked or tweezed, whatever you want to call it, my eyebrows in like a week and a half, 2 weeks. I'm trying to let them grow back because I just am tired of having to draw them on. I don't draw all of them on. It's like half of it, but I'm just tired of doing that. So I want to let them grow back in. And my eyebrows look probably darker today because today I used dark brown and I used something totally different that I already had, which is the Benefit eyebrow thing. It's like a little mascara thing. I just used that on my eyebrows and like this Ofra pencil underneath. And that was it. So it could look like really, really natural. And they're probably not as wide as they normally are. I'm funny with eyebrows. One minute I like something, one minute I don't. One minute I like something, one minute I don't. But I think I like this width the best. Sometimes they're wider, but I don't need them. I mean, I could have them wider because I got enough head right here. But you know what I'm saying? So, yes. So yeah, that's what's on my eyebrows, like this eyebrow mascara. So it looks just like my brows. And I just want something that looks like really, really natural. You know what I'm saying? So, on that note, I'm going to stop talking so much. And we're going to get into this real talk. So, if you guys have a real talk video or issue or some shit like that that you want to be talking about, you can always send me an email to muffinismylovers2012@gmail.com. And please change the name of the subjects in the line. So, if your name is really April, but you don't want nobody to know because you think the whole world is going to be watching me and know that it's you talking about Joseph or whatever, then just say, well, I've already changed the name to you to such and such. And that's fine. We could do that. Please put in the subject line, real talk. Okay? And other than that, let's get this real talk done. Okay, so this one is pretty damn long, but it's a good one because it's like, dang people, some motherfuckers is just as messy. But yes, I love when people send me pictures too. It could be a picture of not anything because I don't want to see a picture of your penis. But you know what? That's funny that I say that because there was this guy. I don't know where he got. Well, obviously he got my email off of YouTube or whatever or Instagram. I don't know. But he kept sending me like 6-7 times. He sent me pictures of his dick. Like, I was like, I opened the email one day. And I was in the car with my son. And I was like, okay, I got some emails. And the picture was taking forever to open. Then it opened. I was like, whoa. What the fuck? He just was like how much he loved me and all this weird shit. He had a big dick. But I was like, okay. And I ignored the email. And then he sent me another picture of it. And listen, he kept sending me these pictures and I kept ignoring him. So finally, I said to him in one of the pictures that he sent, I said, if you're going to send a picture to a girl with your dick on it, the least you could do is shave them nappy ass hairs off your balls and around your genital area. I mean, your testicle area and shit. Like, I mean, you got a nice size package, but don't nobody want to see all those nappy hairs? I said, I'm just saying that would be a suggestion. If you're going to send a girl a dick pic, then make sure that you shave. And that's what I sent to him. I sent that back to him. That's what I said, because this was like the fourth picture and you keep sending me these dick pictures and I'm not even replying to you. You know what I'm saying? I'm not even responding, but you keep sending them to me. So at this point I was like, okay, I'm not gonna curse them out, because when you curse people out and go off on them, it just adds flame to the fire, fuel to the fire, and they really want to come at you. So I just was like, you know what? Just a suggestion, and that's what I said, just a suggestion for me. If you want to continue to send women pictures of your dick, what I would suggest is shaving off that nappy-ass hair around your balls and your legs and stuff, because if you shave it, it'll look much better, the picture. I said, you got a nice-sized package, but I would just suggest shaving it. Do you know he wrote me back, and he was like, okay, thank you, and never heard from him again, okay? Never heard from him again. I'm not like I saying I want to, but yeah, if you want to send somebody a picture of your dick, could you please shave? Don't nobody want to see some nappy ass curled up, tight, coiled up motherfucking hairs, okay? Seriously. Them shits was coiled the fuck up. Like, nigga, go shave, okay? Nigga, go shave your dick hairs, okay? For real. So anyway, that's what I'm going to call this video if I don't forget. This is a long one, so we're going to get into this, okay? You can call me Courtney. My name is blank. I'm 19, going to be 20 in March. This situation is not specifically about me, but it does affect me, okay? So for about 7 months now, my aunt has been living with us at my mom's house. The only people that lived here before were me, my mom, and my brother. Last year, I was away at college for spring, summer, and fall. But now I'm back home at community college. My aunt is renting out my room from my mother while she gets back on her feet. They did not have a set date on when she needed to be out, but so there is no telling when she gonna leave. Long story short, she needs to go. Let me just give you a backstory. My mom finalized her divorce in December of 2015. And once my stepdad moved out, it was so peaceful. I was away at college and my mom and little brother had the house to themselves. I would come home, the house would be nice and clean, and the refrigerator always had groceries. Fast forward to my aunt Sam moving in. So Sam must be short for Samantha. My mom is equally as stressed out as when my stepdad lived here. Sam is so disgusting. She's in her late 40s and my mom is in her early 40s and has to tell her that she needs to clean out the tub. She keeps my bathroom so nasty to the point where me and my brother don't use it anymore. One time I had a party for my soap business at my house and she didn't even take the initiative to clean the bathroom, so I had to do it myself. I lifted up the toilet seat and it was so disgusting, like it hadn't been cleaned for months. I told my mom and my mom mentioned it to her and she had the nerve to blame it on my 10-year-old brother. My mom told her, my kids don't use this bathroom, which is true. We both use my mom's bathroom. About 3 weeks ago, my mom's friend from Tampa came down. We live in South Florida, to stay with us for the weekend. I had to ask my aunt if the bathroom was clean, which I knew it wasn't. And she did it right before they came. This is a grown-ass woman. This is a grown-ass woman I'm telling to clean the bathroom. My room is slowly becoming a dumpster because of her. And while I was at college, a lot of my shoes were still in my closet, because at school, I mostly wore the same shoes every day. This lady had the nerve to ask me if she could wear a pair of my $300 loafers to work. I told her no. Yeah, we wear the same shoe size, but my feet are narrow and hers are fat. I take very good care of my shoes and I don't like my shits all creased up and bent. Oh my God, it sounds like my son. In her eyes, she was looking at like, oh well, she doesn't wear them, so I might as well. Like, what the fuck? Same with my mom's alcohol. She has a bar and she collects liquor and wine. She has for years, especially when we go out of the country, she'll collect liquor and wine. Sam asked if she could open a bottle of her liquor. My mom told her, hell no. So she went and told my grandma that my mom was being stingy with her stuff. Every day when my mom gets home from work, my brother and I know to leave her alone until she changes her clothes and gets settled in. My aunt will walk directly in her room right when she gets off work and start talking to her about bullshit and be all in her face and won't leave the room and just sit on the bed. She gets on my mom's nerves. My mom won't say anything and I'm sick of it. Or if my mom is already home, if Sam is just getting home, she won't even put her bags down. She will walk straight to my mom's room and start talking. Sam and my mom had an agreement to alternate cooking Sunday dinner and every other weekend. Sam goes to her daughter's house to watch the kids, so when it's her Sunday to cook, she won't come home to cook. She will come late Sunday night. She also doesn't buy groceries unless it's for herself, when she knows that whenever her or my mom goes grocery shopping, it's supposed to be for the entire house. One time she went grocery shopping and my brother asked her to bring some juice. She said, I don't drink the juice. And my brother said, aren't you supposed to be shopping for the whole house? Let's just say she brought the juice. Now my mom barely goes grocery shopping because she doesn't want her to be eating or drinking all of our stuff. I can go on and on and on, but this is the last thing I'm going to tell you. She will leave food out on the counters in the kitchen and never throw it out or put it away. For example, if she is cooking and she is cooking and chopping onions, she will leave the whole onion and the knife on the counter. She'll leave it on the counter, food on the counter, overnight, unless you tell her to go clean up. Or if she cooks and there was extra, she will leave the extras out all night. As I am typing this, there is food on the stove, and that has been there since last night. Let's see how long it's going to take and stay for her to remove it off the counter. And she will not take old food out of the refrigerator and empty it. She will just let it stay there unless my mom does it. And she won't even touch the dishes unless they are hers, sometimes. She won't even wash out her grandson's cups when he comes over. Her daughters want her to move in with them to watch her kids, but they live in a two-bedroom condo, and there is no room because there is already 5 people living there, so she chose to stay here with us. Her daughter said, you are over there helping them out, but you can be here helping me. But nobody asked her to come over here, and she's not helping us. She's only getting on our nerves. Oh, also, I had to record... I had a record vinyl, a vinyl record in my room of one of my favorite singers because I want a collection when I get my first house. It was brand new, unopened in the plastic, and this bitch was using it as a coaster. Oh, shit. You can tell she spilled something on it. The thing about all of this is that when she had her apartment, it was always clean. Like, what the fuck? She didn't even want nobody sitting on her furniture. My mom says she's going to explode and we're not going to like it. She always taking her anger out on the wrong people. I told her to explode on a grown ass woman that is keeping her house a dump. I clean, but if there's nothing, if there's nobody helping maintain it, what am I supposed to do? What to do, April? I'm attaching pictures of her nastiness. Okay, so the room, the hallway mirror decoration in the room on the floor. Why? Wow. So she's taking off wall shit and bringing it in her room. And she got the wig just thrown on top of the dresser like it ain't nothing. She got cups on the floor, shit all over the floor. Like, a crock pot of grease she never put away. The place on the wall where the mirror should be. The stuff. Wow, the hangers in the wall. Looks worse in person, I promise. The nasty tub. Oh, I can see it. Okay, let me tell y'all something. First of all, I've had said this in many videos before, okay? Seriously. For real. It's nasty. When you let somebody come live with you and it be like family, it seems like they just don't give a fuck. They be the nastiest people. They don't help. And I've said this many times. I'm not letting nobody come stay with me no more. I've already been through that with my son and his girlfriend and my grandson. And that bathroom downstairs, which was my 18-year-old son's room, you know, my 18-year-old son gave them the room to stay in. And his bathroom, because there's three bathrooms and everybody's got their own bathroom. My girls share a bathroom. Wuzzle, my 18-year-old, whose bedroom is downstairs, he has his own bathroom. And I have my own bathroom. So, Wuzzle wouldn't even use the bathroom downstairs anymore, his bathroom, because my son and his girlfriend, my son's little family was in there. But, you know, he would use it to shower and take a bath and go to the bathroom. He didn't even want to do that anymore because it got so nasty in there. And my son, Wuzzle, whose bathroom it originally was, he's not the cleanest person in the world. So, if he's not trying to use it, y'all bitches know that shit was unfucking touchable. So, when they finally moved out, okay, it took me 2 hours to clean that bathroom out. Like, it should never take anybody 2 hours to clean the bathroom. It is because I had to scrub the tub so motherfucking hard. Like, how do you take a bath and a shower in a nasty, filth, dirty tub? My rugs were filthy. I waited for them to move out so I could get my rugs clean again and everything. Like, they just had my house a mess. And I don't really, listen, I'm not, maybe not the neatest person in the world. And I have showed y'all that in one of my vlogs. Like, sometimes I have clothes on my floor. But look, y'all bitches could look right motherfucking now. I have cleaned up all of that shit. So, okay. That stuff hanging on the back of my door right there is my scarves, my head wrap scarves, okay? So this is my room, and that bag right there is stuff that I have to review. So my room is motherfucking clean now. I done got all them clothes off the floor. Excuse me, there we go. All them clothes off the floor, and I have done what the fuck I'm supposed to do. I can't really live with a dirty house for too long. Like, that's just not me. And it don't even have to be dirty. I just can't live with an unorganized house for too long because I just get real antsy and I just can't sit around shit like that all the time. But first of all, let's just say this, my dear. Let's just say this, Courtney. You went away to college and your mom rents your motherfucking room out. Like, okay, when is that bitch gonna fucking move out? Because where are you sleeping at that she rented out your room? I'm pretty sure that was a 3-bedroom house, because if y'all had a 4-bedroom, which would mean like a guest room, your aunt would be up in that motherfucker, but she in your room. So you, for one, are being inconvenienced because now you home, you live there, you helping with bills, you helping with cleansing and taking care of the home, and you got this woman in there who, okay, she might be paying rent, but you leaving the house a fucking filthy mess. Let me tell you something. it's nice and it's great if you're able to help your family members out, you know what I'm saying, and do stuff for them and take them in and help them get on their feet. But when they start taking advantage of you and they not doing what the fuck they supposed to do and they just making your life a lot more hectic, then that's the part where it's like, you know what? You give yourself a headache and you give yourself all this unwanted and unneeded stress. And also, you just feel like, damn, let me just rough this out because this is family and I'm trying to help her. And some things you just try to do on your own and not deal with it. I get it. I get like that too sometimes here. Let's just mind you that I have a 4-bedroom home and I have 4 kids and my grandson that live here. So my grandson and my daughter Tati share a room. My son Wuzzle, he's downstairs with his stuff. And Mumsy and my daughter Nay share a room. You know what I mean? But Mumsy's never in there. She's always with me. So me and Mumsy share a room, basically. Mumsy got her own room and she still be up in here. God. I'm the one that's supposed to have their own room, but my 14-year-old daughter, she got her own room because Mumsy don't want to be in there. I mean, Mumsy does go in there from time to time, but mainly she's with me and I like the company. But I be having to get on them too because I be like, damn, the house is a mess. Y'all need to do something. I'm tired of washing it, cleaning it. Basically, I be going off. Sometimes I don't. I just try to be like, I'm going to just do it myself. Just let me do it. But it doesn't go down like that. So then I end up doing it too many times. And then that's when I fucking spaz out. And then they be looking at me like, I'm the bad guy because I don't went off like, oh, she crazy, she going off, she's so mean, she always yelling at somebody, etc., etc. Because this is what I do. Because I'm not going to keep telling you to clean something the fuck up, clean it up, clean it up, clean it up, and then you don't clean it up, you just fucking leave it and then be like making me feel like, oh, well, I'm the merry maid, I could do this shit for y'all. But no, it doesn't work like that. I'm not the motherfucking merry maid. I'm the mother. And I pay 85% of the bills around here. So I would expect y'all motherfuckers to clean this shit up. It's a bad thing when you live with somebody and they just don't know how to be clean and clean up after themselves. That shit is not cool. I don't like that shit. And I know exactly how the fuck you feel. And you guys are just trying to be real cordial and real calm about the shit. Let me tell you something. There is no calmness to that dirty madness, okay? If you've then said it enough motherfucking times, you need to have a talk with your mom and let her know, listen, we need to give Auntie a set date of when she can move out. Because this is really an inconvenience. And I know that you're being inconvenienced and you're aggravated. But you need to give her a set date of when to move out. Because this is your home. Don't nobody want bugs and roaches up in their shit. Because them is the worst motherfucking creatures that don't pay rent to get the fuck rid of. Seriously. Nobody wants a goddamn nasty ass roach to be up in their fucking shit. So what I would do is I would have a talk with my mom first and tell her, mommy, listen, you need to have a talk with your sister and give her a set date that she'll move out. I'm pretty sure the rent money is great extra income to help out. But here's the thing. Sometimes that shit just don't matter. You be just like so through. Like seriously. Like you don't even give a fuck about nobody's extra income. You just be like so ready for the person to get the fuck out. Like just motherfucker, bitch, just motherfucking go. Like seriously. You just be ready to tell the person, get the fuck out. I don't care if you don't have nowhere to stay. I don't give a fuck if I was saving $400 a month. Bitch, get the fuck out. You have 30 days to get out. And if she been staying there for that long, how long is it going to take her to get on her feet? She's a grown-ass woman. She ain't got no kids to take care of because you've already said she has grandkids and all her kids are grown. So therefore, why is she staying with your mother now? She grown. She only need a studio apartment. She don't need a house. She don't need a 1-bedroom. A studio will suit her needs just fine. And dirty that shit the fuck up, okay? Or like her daughter kept asking her, why don't you go live over there, okay? Because there's 5 people already living there. Oh, well, there'll be 6 motherfuckers up in that 2-bedroom apartment. Or why don't you go and get your own shit? A studio works well. Shit, rent yourself a motherfucking room. Because it looks like you living out of that shit. Got fucking shit all on the counter. You need to give her a time frame of when she needs to get the fuck out. Like, seriously, when she gets out, then you guys have your home back. Let me tell you, I don't mind helping anyone, but I feel like when you start taking advantage of me and you start getting lazy and it's like you don't give a fuck, then you know what? I start getting really, really irritated, and I don't like to be irritated as a person, so I just don't really say a lot because I know the type of person that I am. Like, if the way I will come and say something to people sometimes will be taken as the wrong way, or it should be taken that way, but I'll just come off as so aggressive. So sometimes I don't say anything to even my kids here about washing the dishes or something, because I know if I say something, it's gonna come off as being so mean that I don't want to hurt anybody's feelings. So sometimes I try not to say anything, but I just sometimes I'd be hoping like, well, because I'm not saying anything and I haven't been saying anything, maybe they'll take the initiative to do something about it. But then they don't fucking do that. And then it's like, okay, bitch, now you about to explode on these motherfuckers because they just walking all over you like you the Merry Maid motherfucking service. You know what I'm saying? And it don't go down like that. I'm not the neatest person sometimes, because sometimes I get so much things that I just put it down for a minute and then I get tired or whatever. So, but I'm not dirty. That's one thing that I'm not dirty. Sometimes my room might be a little messy. My makeup desk might be a little messy, but I do clean it up. I do clean it up. But yeah, me personally, let me tell you something. That's y'all home. Don't be uncomfortable and feel uncomfortable in your home. That shit is crazy. You need to have a set date of when she's going to move out. And if she feels some type of way about it, then, oh, well, sorry for you. But we would have never had to feel this way if you didn't put us in this predicament. And on top of that, you need your room back. That's you guys' home. She wants to rent a room. That was fine. That was good for the moment. And now it's time to move on your merry fucking way. Okay? Move on your merry motherfucking way and find your own shit. So my suggestion, Courtney, talk to your mom and ask her if she would be willing to have a conversation with your aunt about setting a date and time of when the fuck she gonna move out. By this certain date, your ass got to be moved the fuck out. Bottom line. You guys won't be stressed out no more. Trust me when I tell you that. Hey girl, my name is Hannah. I have been subscribed to you on the YouTube YT for a while. I would really like some advice. My homegirl has just gotten into a new relationship with this man who left his wife for her. Her man and his wife just recently had... Oh, her man and his wife just recently had a newborn baby who is now a month old. My friend is now playing mommy to the new baby. She has a 2-year-old already. I have talked to her mom, letting her know that I'm happy she is in a new relationship. Her mother thinks that she is a fallback and her man is only going to be there for a short term. My question is, what do I tell my friend? She refuses to listen to everyone. Her man has even reached out to several girls in our group trying to flirt with us. Should I butt into the relationship and voice what's going on, or should I just lay back, watch what happens? Thank you so much and have a blessed day. All right, girlfriend, Hannah. So, your friend basically is fucking a married man. This married man then left his wife for your friend's ass, and his wife just had a newborn baby. So now she playing mama to the newborn baby. I doubt she's playing mama to anybody's newborn baby, especially if that's his wife still. Because if I was the wife that just had a baby and my husband fucking left me, you best believe your new little bitch that you left me for, she ain't coming nowhere near my motherfucking baby. She ain't playing house mother to nobody. Bitch, you better hope that you see him or able to see his ass, because I might cut his motherfucking throat and dick off to where you ain't gonna wanna want him anymore. I'm just saying. That's how I would do it. But your friend's stupid and she just fall back. Never heard that one. Rebound chick. She's really not that irrelevant, because if he's on social media or in groups flirting with y'all motherfuckers, then he ain't giving really two fucks about nobody. I'm sorry, but this is my thing. Even if you were digging me and I was digging you and you was having an issue in your relationship, I'm not gonna fuck with you because you're married. And for two, you married and your wife is about to have a baby. That says a lot about you as a person, as your character, about what type of person you are in general. If you could leave your wife to go be with somebody else, leave your pregnant wife. If a man can do that, then that says a lot about him as a person. However, if you've already said something to her about it and she is non-responsive to it, then you know what? The fuck you need to do is just sit the fuck back and let it all take place. Because I guarantee you, her fucking story is not going to be one that's happily ever after. That bitch is not going to run off or ride off like Cinderella with the Prince Charming and go live in some big motherfucking castle and have a stepchild or anything like that. That's not going to be the story or the outcome for her. But if y'all's already been telling her and she is not listening to nobody, then you know what? She going to have to learn on her own. Sometimes some people are just left better yet not helped. Because you can tell somebody something until you blew in the motherfucking face. They are not going to take heed to the shit until they're ready to take heed to it. That's just like telling your friend, stop letting him beat on you. Stop letting him beat on you. Leave him. They'll be like, yeah, girl, you right, you right. But then they're not really going to leave until they're ready to leave. So some things you just got to leave alone. Because if you keep coming at her about her relationship, she's probably going to think that you're jealous or that your relationship isn't like hers or whatever the situation may be. Bitches get like that. And if you were to tell her, yeah, that's why he's flirting with us or who and so, she's also still going to be like, oh, you're lying and you're making all this up because you're just jealous. And then that's going to ruin y'all friendship. So to avoid doing all of that, what I would do, since you've already said something, is I would just let it play itself out. You know, just let it play itself the fuck out and see what happens. When she comes to you, because she's going to come to you crying and distraught, then you let her know, hey, you know, you ain't got to be like, oh, I told you so. You don't have to tell her that. But you could just be a friend and be like, well, you know, I'm here for you. I'm sorry that this happened to you. You know, I kind of, you know, tried to warn you, but I'm still here for you. You ain't got to be like, I told you so, girl, I told you, blah, 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 blah. Just leave it as it is and let it play itself out. Because like I said, regardless, you're going to want to keep telling her and she's not going to listen. So why the fuck bother? I'm sorry, but I'm not going to keep telling somebody something over and over and over and over and over the fuck again. If you're a grown ass woman and you know this shit, you should know better. But on top of that, you should know better than to fuck with somebody's husband, especially if they're having a baby together. Like, I don't know about anybody else, but I just don't do shit like that. Maybe it's because I have a different way about myself, so I don't get down like that. But if it were I would just leave the situation alone. Be there for her as a good friend. But to some people, you can't keep saying shit to because they'll just take it in the wrong way. You know what I mean? I think it's kind of fucked up that she is like a rebound chick. He don't give a fuck about her. But just leave it the fuck alone. She'll figure it out on her own. Shit, you want to be somebody rebound, bitch, then go right the fuck ahead. But worry about you. Just worry about you. So this is the last email, and like I said, I love to get pictures, okay, because I just love to get pictures. It allows me to see who I'm talking to and so forth. So yes, let's see who this story is about. Okay, all right, real talk. So a bitch can't have a friend, real talk. So she titled it and everything. Hey April, I'm a big fan of yours. I've been watching you since Mumsy was a toddler. You are one of the first YouTubers I've ever subscribed to. I never miss Real Talk on Wednesday, and I wear wigs because of you. I'm just going to get straight to the point because this is a long one. I'm changing my name to Moet. When I was 22, I had my own place. I was going to college and working two jobs to take care of my son. My son's dad, we're going to call him Henny. He was my first everything. He stayed with me, and he told me he was working. Come to find out, this Negro decides he wants to sell drugs. I found this shit stashed in my house. I kicked him and his drugs the fuck out. He left and stayed with a little hood booger who let him keep drugs in her house. A few months later, he got locked up. I told him I wasn't going to put my life on hold for a dude who was going to do something I didn't approve of. Plus, he wasn't my man at the time of his arrest anyway. I started dealing with another man named Patron. All her names are drinks. He was cool. He had a good head on his shoulder. Good job. The sex was amazing. However, I've never been one to be dick dizzy over no dude. I didn't want to be serious with him because I wanted to be selfish and just focus on and only have to worry about myself and her kid. He respected it, or so I thought. One day I was at work and I turned my phone off. Girl, this man called me 63 times that day, texting me crazy shit like, where you at? Who are you with? What the fuck you doing? I ignored all of that and went to pay my bills and go shopping with Henny's sister after work. So Henny is her baby daddy's sister, okay? Her kid's aunt, okay? Let's call that ungrateful bitch MD2020. So she called her baby daddy's sister MD2020. I got to my building and I was headed to pick my son up from his babysitters who lived upstairs from me. April, how about this dude was sitting on his car across the street from my building? I looked up, he hopped off the car and started jogging towards me. I took off and ran in the building. I turned around and he was tackling MD2020 to get to me. I got to the second floor and had to remember who the fuck I was. I turned around and walked back down the stairs and cursed his ass the fuck out. He left and we didn't talk for weeks. He called, apologized, and everything was cool. We ended up being friends over the years whenever he wasn't in a relationship and I wasn't in one. If I had an itch that needed to be scratched, he was my dude. I would always stop if I felt him trying to get serious on me. Because in all my honesty, my heart was still ex. He has made it very clear that he always has and always will want more from me. But he'd rather have me as a friend than to not have me in his life at all. We have the best conversation. He respects my mind and vice versa. I'm just not interested in being his woman. But Patron, which is the one I'm talking about, is one of the few people who has always wanted to see me win in life. He's been an amazing friend. Once we sorted out his little issues in the beginning, MD 2020, which is my baby daddy's sister, was homeless and needed a place to stay when her family kicked her out after finding out she was gay. She left one night to go out and said she would be gone overnight. I called Patron over. And when I was walking him to the door the next morning, MD2020 was asleep on my couch. She said she heard us getting it on and she wouldn't tell her brother, my baby father. I told her I didn't give a fuck if she did because we weren't together. She still claimed that my personal business was just that and she wouldn't say a word. Now here's where the shit comes into play. Henny did 5 years in prison. He came home over 4 years ago, got a decent job, and got his degree. We started talking again because he turned his life around, which is her baby daddy. Okay? Right? Yes. And I always wanted to raise my son with him as a family. I'm taking it slow with him because he needs to be very clear about what I will and will not accept. He does not approve of the friendship because he knows that me and Patron have had sex in the past. MD2020 told his ass about the sex. April, I don't give a fuck. Despite anything, Patron has been a great friend to me. I have learned a lot from him. He has been there for me and has supported me for the last decade when no one else has. I admit I fucked him, but never when I was in a relationship and never when I was and never when he was in one, because I just don't roll like that. So I don't see the issue. I don't feel like Henny, my baby father, has the right to decide who I can and cannot have in my life. I have no intention of getting rid of Patron because no matter what, he has always been there for me. Am I wrong for that? Do I need to check myself? Is it time to let the friendship go? Please, girl, let me know something. Thank you for your time. A lifelong subscriber, Moet. P.S. I bet you anything that nosy bitch who thought you were recording in your daughter's room more than likely sleeps on a mattress on the floor. Just saying. Laugh out loud. Oh, my God. OMG. And she's so fucking pretty, too. Oh, my God. She has, like, the prettiest lips. They're so full. And the prettiest eyes. Oh, my God. And her wig is on fleek. She's so pretty. So, I don't really know which. Okay, Henny. This is her baby daddy. And he's handsome. And they look cute together. You know how you have this couple and they look cute together. Her baby daddy and her. Now, then we have Patron. Patron cute, though, too. He's a cutie. And I don't know. I'ma just be honest with you, Moet. You better keep Patron because he ain't ugly. He look good, girl. Okay, on top of that, you ain't even with your baby father. So, first of all, how you gonna tell somebody how to live their life and who to be with when you ain't even with me? You know what I'm saying? I'm pretty sure your baby daddy, Henny, is out there living life, sleeping with whatever bitch he wanna sleep with, fucking with whoever he wanna fuck with. And if he ain't, That's his business. You're not his girlfriend. You're not in a relationship with him. So what does it even matter? And far as his sister is concerned, okay, MD 2020, I remember drinking that as a teenager one time, a few times. That shit will get you fucked up. I have woke up on the floor from MD 2020 and Cisco, okay? So if y'all motherfuckers have drank that and know what the hell I'm talking about, let's just put hashtag down below which one, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, like me personally, that would be like some shit like with me and my ex-husband. Like if we ain't together, why would his sister go and tell some business? I'm just saying, like with this, Patron has been your friend. He's been there for you. You guys don't want to have a serious relationship, or you don't want to have a serious relationship with him, but you can see him getting into your, in his feelings about you. Why don't you want to have a serious relationship with him if you just stated to me that he's the one that's always been there for you? He's been a good friend. He's always supported you, and he's always supported your decisions in life and whatever. And whenever you need him, he's always there. But you didn't say anything like that about your baby daddy, Henny. The only thing you said is he was your first and you always would love him. And that's probably what's kind of got you stuck to where you don't want to move on into a relationship with Patron. However, I don't hear you saying nothing about Henny and you getting back together, nothing about Henny doing what the fuck he's supposed to do and make life better for you. Though I'm pretty sure you guys want to be together and raise a family together. And is that because you guys have a kid together? Sometimes just because you guys have a kid together, it doesn't always mean that it's the best thing for you, for him, or the child. You know what I'm saying? What's best is for the child to be with both parents. Yes, true indeed. But maybe sometimes those both parents don't supposed to be together, because that just makes the kid more confused and life hectic. Let me tell you something. If it were me and this person, Patron, was always there for me and he's always supported my decisions and supported me mentally and physically and maybe financially, and he's always been a really good friend and he has wanted to be in a relationship with me, then I would give it a try. Because how are you to know that this person that you're holding off for, which is your baby father, is going to be the right person for you only because you're your first? Sometimes the first is not always supposed to be our last. You know what I'm saying? Like, seriously, just because he's our first don't mean that he's supposed to be our last and we're supposed to be with him. Because if that's the case, then I would have been with my first still too. You know what I mean? But he was an asshole, so why even bother? But me personally, my opinion, I would try to make it work out with Patron. Though, granted, yeah, it's cool. You want to be with your baby father. I'm not knocking that. But if he's not trying to take no initiative and he's not trying to be along with it and do what he's supposed to do, then why the fuck is you straggling along and waiting for something? You know what I'm saying? And on top of that, it's none of his fucking business who you friends with and who you fuck with. Y'all ain't together. That's not your man, okay? So, therefore, he needs to mind his motherfucking business. And what you need to do, Moet, is focus on you, your son, and happiness. And if Patron is making you happy, then what I think you should do is try to take that leap of faith and maybe try to work something with him. And maybe that would be your life and things would be a lot better for you. But I wouldn't be worried about chasing after somebody with some iffy attitude. One minute you want to be there, one minute you don't. You don't really want to be doing what you're supposed to do. Listen, happiness in life is short, okay? And life is too short to be sitting around waiting for somebody to get their shit the fuck together when they been should have done did that. And then you got someone over here who's willing to do everything for you, support you, and do everything you ask them to do, okay? Why would you let something good go for something that's mediocre? Like, I'm just saying. You know what I'm saying? Think about what I'm saying. Nah, you shouldn't end the friendship, and maybe you should make the friendship go a little bit further with Patron. I'm just saying, girlfriend, he cute, so... And cuteness ain't everything, but it seems like he got good qualities that you were talking about. So, what's up? You know what I'm saying? Like, what's up? So, on that note, I hope you guys enjoyed this really Valentine's Day. I hope you guys had an amazing Valentine's Day. I hope you guys enjoyed this really video, this real talk video on Valentine's Day. And I hope you guys had an amazing Valentine's Day as well. And on that note, make sure you give the divas your advice down below. I love you all. And like I said, if you done drank MD 2020, put hashtag MD 2020. Or if you done drank Cisco, put hashtag Cisco. Because I really don't want to be the only motherfucker out here in the world now that remembers drinking that shit as a kid. Okay? Not as a kid, but you know, as like in the 18, 20 year old time period. I remember waking up that time. One time we had came from this Tupac concert. And because, you know, Tupac was in New York City, and I had front stage. It was like this little concert kind of club light right there. I think it was right there, okay? Did he fucking come down on the thing? Who, I will never forget. We danced, you know what I'm saying? We had a dance, kind of like he danced with me. Oof. Long story, but yes, girls, I had Tupac's arms wrapped around me, okay? And that wasn't the first time. Then at this club, on my birthday, Jodeci was there and Tupac was there. And I got an autograph from Tupac and JoJo from KC. And JoJo from Jodeci. Why this nigga gave me his number? He gave me his phone number to call him. Sorry, I never called him because I already knew what that was about. You're not about to get none of this stuff. And I love Jodeci then too, but nah, I ain't about to give you the goods. That was when I was in like my prime time, having good old times, having parties at the fucking club at the Tunnel in New York. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's where the shit went down. But yes, I remember those days, and I remember that one day in particular when I woke up with that Carl Kani suit on. Y'all remember Carl Kani? I had the Carl Kani jacket, vest, and jeans. It was this like burgundy maroon color, and my friend, she had a matching gray one on. Girl, I woke, girls, bitches, whatever y'all want me to call y'all, I woke up the next day on the floor in the bathroom. So y'all already know what time it was. So, yes, I love you guys. Stay diva and divalicious, and I will see y'all on a soon-to-come video.